In book one, Miss Brooke, chapter 4 of Middlemarch, Dorothea and Celia are coming back from Sir James's estate. Celia tells her sister point blank that Sir James is in love with her and everyone's talking about it. Dorothea is shocked, then angry and upset. At home, her uncle, just back from seeing Mr. Casaubon, reveals that the minister has asked permission to propose marriage. She's delighted by this news. Mr. Brooke brings up the fact that Sir James also wishes to marry her, but she's not interested. In the end, Mr. Brooke says he won't stand in her way and gives her the minister's letter. In chapter 5, Dorothea reads Mr. Casaubon's proposal of marriage, which is focused almost entirely on himself and his needs, as he tells Dorothea how she was sent by Providence to help him complete his life's plan. Dorothea receives this lackluster proposal with great emotion and gratitude and immediately answers yes. Celia has begun to surmise that her sister feels more than scholarly interest in Reverend Casaubon, and she's shocked and appalled by the news, but tells her sister she hopes she'll be happy. In chapter 6, Mrs. Cadwallader, an upper-class woman married to a clergyman, visits Tipton Grange. She scolds Mr. Brooke about his liberal political leanings, warning him that he will make a fool of himself if he runs for office. Mr. Brooke tells her Dorothea will not be marrying Sir James. Celia comes in and adds that Dorothea is engaged to Mr. Casaubon. Mrs. Cadwallader, vexed and shocked, leaves and breaks the news to Sir James, and also tells him that Celia is very fond of him, and that he should be courting her. Sir James, upset, resolves to make the best of it. Dorothea, both too humble and too proud, makes a disastrous choice to turn her back on the sensible and charming baronet, Sir James, to pursue an idealistic marriage with an old, lifeless clergyman. She thinks Sir James is too stupid and shallow to marry, an assessment that shows how little Dorothea has reflected on the extent to which other people possess a conscious mind quite as fully developed as her own. Dorothea hardly sees Edward Casaubon. She overestimates him because she wants to assist a brilliant man who's writing an important book. As a result, her extreme gratitude for his narcissistic marriage proposal is misplaced and inappropriate.